My friends, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, let us share with specific people. Now we're sharing with 208 people. I don't understand how this works, but I'm hiding the chat. I just had my mind blown. In fact, it was so blown that I'm talking to you guys on my 3G data, of which I don't have that much. But I had to share this with you before I forgot. As you guys know, I forget and get distracted quicker than you can say squirrel. What was I going to say? That was a joke. Haha. All right, so it turns out we've been talking, obviously this case plus the autism plus all this shit has been bringing out some ridiculous amount of hell. And what has happened is that we are desperately trying to understand how this torment comes, how this humiliation comes, how the self-hatred comes, the not understanding of other human beings, etc., etc. So we were able to today get back to an episode when I was in year four in 1989. And I believe 1989, 1990, I was 9 years old. And after being severely harassed at school by this kid, which was a recurring trend, even I was one of the biggest guys there, but always picked on. This lady picked me up, who was a friend of my mother's, and I was able to talk to her. And it was the first person I was ever able to talk to. Now, my mom lost her shit that I would talk to any other person. But the thing about my mum when I was growing up is that my mum, she's a sweetheart, but she was like a German, man. She was like, don't shut your mouth. You know, like, I'm exaggerating. She was very sweet. But if anyone attacked me for my weird ass behavior, going to my mum would result in my mum saying to me, well, what did you do wrong to make other people dislike you or you know, to piss other people off? So it was always in front of me. My mum was very critical of me. But I didn't know that she was actually my biggest defender to other people. I didn't know this until I was a grown-up, right? I don't think I'm still a complete grown-up. All right, so there was no way to bring this up with Dad because Dad was the biggest cheerleader for Mum in the world, right? So basically, you know, if my mum, you know, had shot me in the arm, my dad would be like, why do you blame your mother? It is not her fault. All right, so, you know, you are a very bad son. You know, I'm exaggerating, right? They were awesome parents, don't get me wrong. So, and everyone has their own problems. Okay, so this then led to shame in wanting to have the desire to share with people what was going on with me as a child. And I was unable to share it with mum and with dad for the reasons I just explained. On top of that, I was severely condemned for even bringing up having to talk about anything about me with a stranger. And so associated with my need to share what was going on was a sense of shame I didn't understand until today with my psychiatrist. I kept thinking it was embarrassment, but it wasn't embarrassment because that's inconsistent with the fact that I don't really get embarrassed at all. It was shame. And so the shame and the subsequent anger which came with that shame was unable to be directed anywhere because I was unable to share it with my family who loved me to death, but was unintentional, like most parents. All of us are human. We don't know what to do properly. And unable to share it with anyone else because of the sense of shame, I then directed the anger towards myself as a young kid and hated myself even more for my odd behavior. When I was picked on, I believed it was my fault for being abused by the other teachers and students. And so I developed a level of self-hatred and, of course, a lack of self-worth, which really grew with me all the way until the third and final suicide attempt, which would have been successful but for my father finding my body. So, you know, it's interesting when you hear this part of the story because you hear that people, you know, people say it's amazing how your parents suffered, that you had to go through that. And now I'm able to say, well, you didn't live with my parents, right? Which I just learned from my psych, which is very interesting because even this other bitch of a lady once said I was a bad kid because, I didn't realize how great my parents were or something like that. And I thought to myself, now I think to myself, you stupid, dirty, mother effing whore bag, right? Like I would love to, you know, harm you very much, you know, in the level of fantasy, right? Not in, obviously not in real life. So that absolutely blew my mind today, and it made me realize, talking with the psych, that the anger which I have been directing towards myself growing up, and turned into self-hatred and resentment, it turns out that that was unfounded. It was not based in any real characteristic or character flaw which I perceived myself to have possessed. It turns out that I was just a young little retarded autistic boy who couldn't speak, walk, or function correctly, but also had savant tendencies. And as we know, you can go to YouTube to Gabsmacked and have a look at the Second Life Autism Speech to see what my brain can do. And that is associated with the disgusting, horrific accusations which are made by an incomplete picture held by some stupid, moronic people who are unable to question their own unconscious biases, which I won't talk about here, but a lot of you know what they are, what's going on. All right, so I now, from today, this is the takeaway, from today, I must learn that a lot of that subconscious self-hatred and that anger and shame in wanting to talk to other people, which I'm doing on Periscope by the freaking hundreds and thousands now, right? None of that is founded in what I thought was a real reason of or justification for that self-hatred. No, fuck that, my friends. Basically, what it is that it was a misplaced direction of anger as a child who was unable to question his parents' unconscious biases and misbehaviors towards their own child. Damn straight, my friends. So now I know I am way more awesome than I thought I was as a kid. I am damn fucking awesome. And I am flawed like every single other human, but not to the extreme that I thought as a child. That is a great day, a great revelation. Awesome to share that with all of you. Yeah. All right, let's bring back the chats. Hello, Gab, hey, okay, Donnie Soldier. That's great, mate. Good job, hey. Either a good job or a job good. Amen. Nikki, it's my time. Damn straight, it's my time. It's now or never. I'm a winner. Hi, Gabby. Hey, Jemima. Congrats, friend. Thank you, Captain Deltron. Excellent revelation. Damn straight. It was an amazing revelation. And count my blessing. Was it just one blessing, was it? Too funny. I'm so glad I shared that with you guys. And I'm now going to go because this is killing my data. I think you're F-kin awesome, Gabby. Thank you, Jemima. Likewise, my dear. And it is great to now start to internalize that at 36 and a half. At 36 and a half, I can now Xander Jelly Bean start to internalize and maybe think, yes, I do have some self-worth. And maybe what I can contribute to society is worth it. I don't need to overcompensate by studying six languages and by, you know, having, you know, five different girlfriends at once and all that stupid shit that I used to do. You are amazing. Likewise, I watched some of your YouTube videos. Wow. Okay. That's a mad ass compliment. Thank you very much. But I am now going to start internalizing some of that from now on. And so I don't have to study six languages anymore. Damn straight. You know what? I'm going to focus on the physics and the maths. We got man bun. Damn straight. Man bun, my friend. Man bun. How are you? All right. That's it. You're sweet. Just saw your dance one when I was wearing the Obama mask and I was just moving around. Or another one. If you go to Sydney Remix DJ, I've got ones where I dressed up in an Obama mask. Love you, seriously. Jemima. All right, Jemima. It would be great if you were in Sydney and then we could love you even more seriously. Cannabis is medicine. I would love to be able to share that thought. Many more breakthroughs to come, Scott. Damn straight. I am so lucky that my life was not ended at 25. I would never have discovered these revelations and then been unable to share them with you guys. This is what justifies that pain. It is, number one, the realization. Number two, sharing it with you guys. It makes it worthwhile. It makes it worthwhile. Motivational speaker, I believe I am right now. So guys, if you can, go to Patreon.com/Gabsmacked and join the team and we can take over the world. Awesome. If you can pre-order the book at GoFundMe, awesome. If you can't do either of those and you're broke like me, then subscribe to YouTube and share these links with everyone, because my goal, I didn't give a damn how it's done, whether it's through money or through cannabis or through... you know, CIPS, awesome, or whether it's through Patreon, or whether we just share these links. Changing the world for the better is my motivation. And if it's your motivation And then together, it's done. PhD with you in Wisconsin. We're getting the book soon. Whatever it is, I don't care, right? Any one of those options, we're going to help the world, right? And it makes me feel awesome, really. So it's a selfish motivation, but why not? It's a good thing to have. Love you guys. Knowledge is power. When it comes to knowledge, drink deep. Eva, this one's for you, Eva. You can rerun this. Book tour, bitches. I'm going to call it the book tour, bitches tour. I might even call it the still here, bitches tour. I'm not sure yet. We'll see how we go. And oh, by the way, congratulations to the Syriacs. Yeah, the Syriacs who were able to set up a new Syriac school in Hummus in Syria. Still here, bitches, man. The original Western civilization from 3,000 to 2,000 years ago that were almost wiped out by the ravaging Islam 1,400 years ago. They've now set up a school in Hummus. They're coming back, man. Still here, bitches!